Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hit the subscribe button down below to help support me in growing my YouTube. Anyways, let's get into today's topic, which is getting our lives together. I feel like a lot more of us are getting into self-improvement during quarantine because, hey, what else do we have to do, right? Anyways, the first thing that I want to talk about that I don't really hear mentioned that often when self-improvement is brought up, and that is setting reminders. Not just setting reminders for things that you have to do, like doctor's appointments, going to work, like those things that are already scheduled, you know? But also making reminders for the things that aren't scheduled, the things you don't have to do, but you should. For example, setting reminders to work out. Even if you're busy and you work a 9-to-5 and you don't have a ton of free time, setting a reminder to go on longer walks on the weekends or get in a real workout or even going on a walk for 15 minutes a day, that is better than nothing. And not only that, but setting reminders for the things you really want to procrastinate on or the things that are easily pushed aside. I'm gonna give you a personal example, and that is for me. I am currently working on learning two languages. Well, one more so than the other, but a lot of times, because that can be hard, it's easier to want to choose to do something easier, choose something that I don't have to put much effort in. So what I do is I set reminders to put time aside for language learning every single day. I have reminders to work out. I have reminders set that are just simply motivational quotes. And having that constantly put in my mind really helps change my mindset, especially over a long period of time. You'll just naturally remember to do these kind of things, mostly because they start to become a habit. We say it takes 90 days to break or form a habit, so it makes sense. I think that after 3 months, you would probably notice a difference in just naturally wanting to do the hard things. So that brings me to the next thing, which is deleting the distracting apps from your phone and just getting rid of distractions altogether. So keeping the TV turned off during the day and deleting social media apps from your phone, turning notifications off except for important things like your work, doctor's offices, whatever. But for me personally, deleting apps from my phone was such a big help because I very rarely use social media now. I could honestly use my Instagram or this page a lot more often, but I don't really get on there and scroll mindlessly. I don't really get on there and engage in negativity. I don't do that at all anymore. But I noticed a big difference in my overall mood now that I'm not consuming all of this stuff that's on social media, and it's wonderful. I know it can be a hard habit to break because we are so used to constantly being online that it can be weird to not be on there. So when people decide to go off of social media, people are like, "What are you doing? Like, why are you being such a millennial?" I don't know. But I promise you, going offline will do so much for your mental health and your productivity. The third thing that I want to talk about is organizing and scheduling, which kind of ties into everything else, especially with setting reminders. I personally, I'm a stay-at-home mom, so I don't have a schedule given to me. I don't have one written out for me. I don't have anyone I have to answer to. So it can be really easy to slack off and not doing anything productive and just watch Netflix in my free time and just, like, relax, I guess. But instead of doing that, I give myself a schedule. I write out things that I need to get done. I write out, okay, so tomorrow from this time to this time, I'm gonna study Spanish. And then for 20 minutes, I'm gonna study Italian. And then, in the morning from like 7 a.m., usually, I take my dog on a walk and I take my daughter with me, and it's about 30 minutes, and I know that every single day we're gonna walk for at least 30 minutes. And I don't let myself have excuses to not do these things. Like, I have to do them. I absolutely have to do these. I have to follow the schedule because I don't have anyone telling me what to do. I don't have anyone holding me accountable but myself. So I have to hold myself to a high standard and be productive because I want to have financial freedom someday. I don't want my husband and I to always have to have a boss and depend on this 9 to 5 in order to survive. With that being said, it takes a lot of self-discipline, and working on it right now, especially while we're young, I think is a really great thing. So, organizing and scheduling your time is something that's really going to help with self-discipline. Other than that, I mean, I know sometimes things don't go according to plan. I know sometimes things can be unpredictable, but still trying to stay as on schedule and organized as you possibly can is important. Doesn't mean that every single second of your day has to be doing something productive. It's important to recharge every once in a while. I like to set time aside to meditate or run a bath, or, every once in a while, my husband and I will watch a funny movie or watch some travel videos on YouTube. We like to go on bike rides, which is productive, but also like recharging at the same time. But make sure you find a balance and that you're really taking care of yourself. Which brings me to my next thing, which exercising and dieting is also going to play a huge, huge role in the way that you feel. Because when you start taking care of yourself, when you start caring about the things that you're eating, you're going to start caring about other things. And not only that, but working out releases those happy hormones in your brain, so you're going to feel a lot better. You're going to have a lot more energy, which means you're going to be able to get things done more often. And not only that, but you're going to be sharper, you're going to be more alert, you're just going to be better all around, you know. And when I say dieting, I don't mean eating less, like a lot of people automatically assume. I just mean pay attention to the things that you're eating. Don't eat so much fast food and processed food and just cheap, junky things, you know. Make sure that you're eating plenty of nutritious foods. I feel like this is kind of common sense, well, it is, but a lot of people just ignore it because they don't care. When you start to care about your body and your well-being, you will start to care about other things in your life. And it will be a lot easier to keep up with the busy lifestyle when you are giving your body what it needs, including sleep. I know sometimes, like, we get busy and it's not possible to get as much sleep as we'd like. But when we stay up and we lose out on sleep because we're too busy on our phone, on social media, or hanging out with people who aren't even good for us in the first place, that's when it becomes a problem. Speaking of people that aren't good for us, how's your social circle? Do the people that you're around reflect the person that you want to be in the future? Because if not, you might want to cut some people off. This just goes as far as like people who are just negative people altogether, people who have no goals or ambitions, they want to party every weekend. Those people aren't good for you. They may not be disrespectful to you, they may not be harming you, but they're gonna drag you down with them, especially when they expect you to do everything that they're doing. Because oddly enough, I've noticed that there are people who have this idea like, well, if I'm not doing good, I don't want my friends to do good, which is so weird and it is toxic. But it also goes to toxic and abusive family and friends. You really want to cut those people out of your life. I know it's really taboo to say cut your family off, but if they're toxic and they don't treat you good, you don't owe them anything because you're blood or you're related. You don't owe them anything. Be really picky about who you have around because you're going to become the people that you're around all of the time. All of this, I feel like, kind of ties together. So I feel like once you start doing one and or two of these things, you're going to slowly start doing everything else. And I know this is one of the bigger ones, so if you want to save this one for last, that's okay. As long as you get on to it eventually, as long as you start thinking about it and paying more attention to how people treat you and how they affect you. pay attention to how you feel after being around certain people. Because I'm going to tell you, once I started paying attention, I definitely noticed how certain people just make me feel so bad. Like, for example, have you ever been so excited about something, so motivated, you're like, I got this, I got a game plan, I'm going to execute it, like, I'm going to do this. And you tell somebody about it, and they just shoot you down and drain you of every motivation that you have, and you just, like, walk away feeling like, I was so stupid to think that, like, I was so stupid to think I could do this, like, now I'm in a bad mood because I'm just like, I realized, like, I can't do this, and it sucks, and, like, I was so happy, and now I'm just down here. Cut those people off, because I'm telling you, they're going to hold you down, and you're never going to get to where you want to be with those anchors around you. These people are, like, such heavyweights, you need to get rid of them. And you're probably going to have those people that's like, oh, but they're family. Who cares? Who cares if they're family? Who cares if you're related to them? Who cares if they're blood? You don't owe them anything. You don't owe your family anything. You don't owe your friends anything. You don't owe anybody anything except yourself. You do owe it to yourself to respect yourself enough to not allow everyone else to control your life. Even if they're blood, even if they're a best friend, even if they, quote-unquote, rely on you. It's another thing. Don't ever let anyone make you feel like you're responsible for their feelings, for their emotional stability, for anything. Unless they're your children. That's not what we're talking about. But I personally have been a victim of this where I feel like I can't cut somebody off because I'm going to hurt their feelings and then I'll feel bad, even though they're hurting me and they're negative to me and they're toxic to me. It's like, yeah, they treat me bad, but I would be mean to hurt their feelings. And it's like, why do I do that? You know, it's something that I'm still working on. I can't say I'm perfect at this, but I think that working on that guilt and that people-pleasing part of us will also help a lot, because I think that does have a big effect, because we feel guilty for having a good life and not letting people misuse us. It's just so weird to me, you know, like, I don't know. That's really all that I'm going to talk about on the topic of, like, friends and family. I think I'll make another video going deeper into this topic, because if I go on and on, this video is going to be mainly about this topic, and I don't want it to be about that. I just want it to be kind of a general, like, let's get our crap together during quarantine kind of video. So, let's talk about the last thing, and that is dressing for success. When I say dressing for success, I don't mean you have to look like you're going to the Met Gala every day, because you don't. What I mean by that is not wearing your PJs all day or your gym clothes all day, just not caring about what you look like. Again, I'm not saying you have to do a full glam makeup every day. You don't have to get your hair perfectly styled every day. It's not what I'm saying. What I am saying is you need to put intention into yourself every day. This could mean wearing jeans and a t-shirt and brushing your hair out. Like, please, like, take care of yourself. I have curly hair, so I understand, like, you can't just brush your hair out and go on about the day. Like, if you brush curly hair, you're gonna look like an alpaca. So, like, just putting some conditioner, leaving conditioner in your hair, putting on a little mascara, and putting on an outfit that makes you feel good. You don't even have to wear makeup, but just taking care of yourself, looking presentable, because when you look good, you feel good. And oddly enough, I've noticed that when I do this, I'm more productive, because when I dress like I'm doing something important, the important things, they feel more fun and less like work. Like, it's so weird. I don't know why. I'm sure there's some psychology behind this. In fact, I could probably make another video on it after I look into it further. But it's like my mood totally changes after my morning shower, after I get out and do my hair, put on a little mascara, and just put on that outfit that I just feel amazing in. I just feel like a completely different person than if I were to wear gym clothes all day, yoga pants all day. Like, I don't know what it is. It's just, it really changes your overall day. Maybe because you feel more professional, so you're excited to get more of those projects done. I don't know. But I don't know, just start putting more intention into yourself every day. Start taking care of yourself. Start being more picky with who's around you. Take care of your body. Take care of your mental health. Just love yourself a little more, I guess. I mean, I guess really that's the whole message of this video, is respect yourself more. Respect your time more. Respect your boundaries and your emotions more. Just give yourself more respect and give yourself more love. And I think once we do that and we start to change our small habits, the small things become the big things. If you leave off on this video with any message from today, I want it to be that. The small things become the huge things. If you have anything you want me to talk about again in the future, go ahead and leave a comment down below. And go subscribe, not subscribe, go follow my Instagram. I will link it down below. It's Miss Valentina Official. Subscribe and share it with your family and friends to help support my channel. I look forward to hearing from you guys, and I look forward to posting another video. Thank you so much for listening. I hope you guys enjoy the podcast style. I think they're a lot easier to make, so I can make them a lot more often. So let me know what you think down below.